clients, meetings, projects, tasks, finances, invoices. These are just some of the things we as freelancers need to manage on a day-to-day basis, and without the right systems in place, this can quickly become overwhelming. Which is why I created this Notion dashboard specifically designed for freelancers, which you can find as the first link in the description. This dashboard also comes with a virtual assistant page containing 100 personalized Notion AI prompts to help you create better offers, generate more leads, and make more money. This video will be a walkthrough on how to use this dashboard, as well as show you how to adapt it to your own life. And so without further ado, let's get started. Let me first give you a quick overview. At the top, you have a navigation bar using the new Notion buttons that will quickly take you to wherever you want to be inside of your dashboard. Then on the left, you have a clock widget, a line graph showing your monthly profits throughout the year, a quick notes section, your meetings database, and then all of your individual pages. Then on the right, you have your projects, your tasks for each project, as well as a calendar view showing both your tasks and upcoming meetings. Before we get into the system itself, let me first show you the virtual assistant page. Whenever you need ideas, help or inspiration in regards to creating good offers, lead generation, growing your agency or digital marketing, you can refer back to your virtual assistant and use one of the 100 personalized AI prompts. Simply click inside of one of these sections and click generate to get some new ideas. When you're done with the prompt and want to reset it, don't delete the whole block, just delete the content inside. And in order to add your own prompt block, simply type in /custom and select the AI block. For this video, I'm not going to be going through each of these 100 AI prompts, as this is something that you can explore and play around with on your own. Now let's get back to the dashboard. We're going to start off inside of the clients page, which contains your CRM and meetings database. Each client can have multiple projects, and each project can have multiple tasks. So before you create any projects or tasks, you want to add a new client to your pipeline. First, they're going to be a lead, then you'll have an interview, and then they move to being a client. Now there's also a status for very important clients, as well as if you're on hold or if you've lost the client. When we click inside of the client, there are a bunch of properties that we can add. The first one is the status, then the company relation, which we'll get to later, and then we have the price properties. We can add the price of the client's project, or if you have an hourly contract set up through Upwork, then you can add your hourly rate and the amount of hours per week to get the monthly amount. This monthly amount will display on your CRM, so if you have a project-based price, then just hide the monthly amount in the properties tab and then just show the project price property. The other properties we can add is when we've last contacted the client, which communication method we're using, a link to their profile, their email and phone number, as well as an archive checkbox which will remove the client from your CRM database. Now at the bottom you'll see you have a simple notes section where you can add important notes about each client, and you also have two relation properties, one for meetings and one for your projects. If we go back to the CRM, you'll see you have a company section where you can add the client's company, link it to your client, select the industry they're in, add a location, the website link, as well as a logo which will show up in the gallery view. At the bottom of the page, you have a meeting section where you can create new meetings, add in the date as well as include a time, so you can add a reminder and get a notification on your phone. And then you can also add the meeting link and passcode, as well as link the meeting to a client or a project. You'll also see at the bottom it generated a section where you can add questions, notes, and the meeting agenda. All of your meetings will show up on the calendar to the right, so you can get the visual overview of all your upcoming meetings. Now if we go back into our client, you'll see the company is now added, and at the bottom is a section for all our meetings that we got with this client. Now let's move on to the next page, which is for the projects and tasks. Here you'll see we have a view showing the status of each project, a view with the projects grouped by the client, which is also the same as the one on the dashboard. We have a calendar view and also a table view. So let's go ahead and create a new project and link it to our client. Underneath the project section, we have our task database. We have a view for today's tasks, a view for tasks after today, a view showing all your tasks grouped according to the project, and also a view showing all the completed tasks. When we add new tasks and link them to our project, you'll see the project's progress bar updating, as well as when we complete them. Now for each task, we also have a priority matrix. So depending on if you select low, medium or high effort and impact, it will display the importance of the task and sort your tasks accordingly. So low effort and high impact tasks needs to be done first, and high effort and low impact tasks need to be done last. In this projects page, you also have a calendar to schedule and move your tasks around, as well as another meeting section at the bottom, but this time it's grouped according to a specific project instead of a client. Now let's go back to the dashboard. In the project section, you'll see all of your tasks for each client, your task database showing all the tasks you need to do for today, as well as a board view of your tasks grouped to the project and a table view. Your tasks will also show up on the calendar, which also contains a second view for your meetings, with the meetings database on the left showing all of today's meetings. And that's pretty much how you use this dashboard to manage your clients, meetings, projects and tasks. Now let's move on to the individual pages, starting with the finance tracker. I already made a full video dedicated to this finance tracker, which you can find through the card above or in the description below. So for this video, I'm just going to do a quick overview on how to use it. But if you want to know how it works and how to add your own line chart, then I'd recommend checking out that video and using the timestamps to skip around. So to start off, at the top you have a summary section showing your total income, expenses and profit for the year, as well as a line graph visualizing your profit for each month throughout the year. Then you have the finance tracker, where you can quickly add new income or expenses, add the amount, link it to an income or expense source, as well as link it to a bank account. The finance tracker has two views for quickly adding a new income or expense for the day, two views for both your income and expenses grouped according to the month, showing the total at the top, as well as a monthly view containing both your income and expenses, also grouped according to the month, but this time showing your total profit for each. Underneath the finance tracker, you have your different bank accounts, which both have a bank balance that will update automatically as you add new income or expenses. And if you click inside a bank account, you can add a starting amount, which is the amount you currently have in your bank account. Then we have the subscription tracker. Here you can add a new subscription, link it to a bank account, add the amount and billing type, which will update the monthly and yearly formulas at the bottom. And then you can also add the type of subscription and the renewal date. And then also don't forget to add an icon. On the right, you'll see your subscription calendar showing all the subscriptions due for the month, and when a subscription is due, simply extend the renewal date ahead with 1 month. And just note that each time a subscription is due, you have to manually add it as an expense to your finance tracker. And then lastly, at the bottom of the page, you have your different income and expense sources, which will show the total amount for each of them. Again, the link to the finance tracker video can be found in the description and will also be inside of this page when you grab this dashboard. Now for the last few pages, first of which is the invoices page. Pretty simple, you can create a new invoice and change its status, you can link it to a client, add the amount due and the due date, which will calculate the summary formula, and then you can also archive the invoices to make them disappear from your database views. You'll see inside the invoice is another page which contains the actual invoice, where you can go and add the invoice number, the date, your details, the client's details, the services rendered, and your bank details at the bottom. Once the invoice is filled out, you want to click on the page menu and export it as a PDF, which will end up looking something like this. Now, if you want to make changes to the invoice template, then just click the drop down next to New, click on Edit, and make the necessary changes inside the template button. Moving on, we have a notebook page, which is pretty straightforward. You have your notebooks at the top, and each notebook can contain multiple notes, which you can use to keep important information. Super simple, but quite useful. Now for the last page in the navigation bar, we have the library. Here you can add links, resources, your portfolio, onboarding pages, Loom videos, and whatever else you might need to share with your clients or just need in order to run your freelancing gig. Now if we go back to the dashboard, you'll see there is one extra page which is for your phone. On your phone, you want to add a Notion widget to this page, and whenever you're on the go and need to quickly write something down, you can just pull up this page, use the button to add a new note, and it will automatically sync your notes to your dashboard, so when you're at your computer again, you can just organize it into your notebook or turn it into a task. And there you go. Now you know how to manage your life as a freelancer using this Notion dashboard, which can be found as the first link in the description. Thank you for watching, and be sure to check out this next video showing you how to use and set up the finance tracker covered in this video.